Hello everyone. In this video, I will show you how you can make a digital potentiometer using a microcontroller to get a variable output voltage. You may be familiar with potentiometers. They are used in many applications. You can often see them as rotary knobs that control volume on sound equipment, to control voltage and current on power supplies, and many others. As an electronic component, potentiometers come in various shapes and sizes. A potentiometer is a variable resistor, which is a resistor whose resistance value can be varied from 0 to a maximum value, which is marked on it. In this video, I will show you how we can mimic the working of a potentiometer using an 8051 microcontroller and few resistors to get a variable output voltage. So let's begin. Out of many applications, potentiometers are often used as voltage dividers, where we connect the corner pins of the potentiometer to a voltage supply and use the center pin to get a variable voltage. Before I show you how you can create a potentiometer with microcontroller, see its working principle. Internally, a potentiometer will have a resistance strip, usually made of carbon material. Both ends of this strip are brought out for connections, across which we will get a constant resistance, which is marked on the component. A third contact is provided, which slides onto this strip, which gives us a different resistance value based on the position of the sliding contact. Let's assume the position of the slider is at the center, and the ends are connected to a 5-volt supply. In this position, slider divides the total resistance into half on each side, hence dividing the voltage into half. That is, we will get a voltage of 2.5 volts when the slider is exactly at the center. If we move the slider towards 5 volt contact, the voltage will increase towards 5 volts. It is important to note that when this happens, the resistance between the 5 volt contact and the slider will decrease, while the resistance between the slider and the ground pin will increase. To make a digital potentiometer, we have to mimic this behavior of change in the value of resistance between the contacts. To do this, I connected 8 10 kilo ohm resistors to one of the ports of an 8051 microcontroller and connected all the other ends of the resistors together to a common point. This common point will behave like the center pin of the potentiometer, where we will get variable voltage output. On the programming side, we have to configure the port as an output port. Next, write a hex value of 00 to the port, which will connect all resistors to ground, which will give us 0 volt at the common point. Next, writing 1 to the first pin of the port will connect the first resistor to 5 volt, while all other resistors are still connected to ground. The equivalent circuit of this state will be like this. There is one 10k resistor between 5 volt and the common point, and other 7 10k resistors to ground. These 7 resistors are in parallel, hence will give an equivalent resistance of 1.43 kilo ohm. From voltage divider rule, we will get a voltage of 0.62 volt, which is exactly what I got. Next, writing 1 to the next pin of the microcontroller will connect one more resistor to 5 volt and remove one resistor from ground, whose equivalent circuit will look like this, giving an equivalent resistance of 5 kilo ohm on top of the center point and 1.67 kilo ohm at the bottom, which will give a voltage of 1.25 volt. Similarly, writing 1 to the third pin will give a voltage of 1.3 volt. Writing 1 to the fourth pin will connect 4 10k resistors to 5 volt and other 4 10k resistors to ground, creating an equivalent resistance of 2.5 kilo ohm on top and 2.5 kilo ohm on the bottom, which will give 2.5 volts, which is exactly half the supply voltage. Similarly, writing 1 to the 5th pin will give 3.5 volts. With 6th pin, we'll get 3.7 volts with 7 pins will get 4.3 volt, and finally writing 1 to all 8 bits will give 5 volt. For doing this on a microcontroller board, you can use a 9 pin 10K SIP package, which is commonly found on 8051 boards at port 0. Solder a wire to a common point, which is indicated by the white dot on the component, where we will get our variable voltage output. Using 8 pins of the microcontroller will give 8 different voltage values. To have more resolution, you can connect more 10K resistors to other pins of the microcontroller and connect the other ends of the resistors to a common point. Start by writing zeros to all the pins and start writing 1 to pin in sequence to get a variable output voltage. You can further add a small potentiometer to further reduce the maximum voltage to a desired value and get even finer voltage resolution. This concludes this video. If you think of any applications for this technique, mention in the comments below. In my next video, I will show you how you can use this technique to make a battery voltage charge monitoring circuit together with Atmel's 4051 chip using its analog comparator. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't. See you again later.